Hey guys, what's up? RetroMikey78 here today, and today we are gonna go over my OG Xbox collection. What games do I own, and what have I played, and what do I have in this set? Now, reason I'm doing this is I watched Linda, aka the Gamer Girl, do her PS2, PS1, and she just did her Xbox 360 collection. So I really enjoyed those videos, and I thought, you know what? That's something I can do and give you guys a shout out of what I got during this quarantine, since I don't have any other pickups videos or other things like that going. Now, I'm not going to do the N64, the GameCube collection. I will not be doing those. So you guys know, you guys have been following me. You guys know what I need for those and what I have. Now, I did do a poll, and this is what came up first, was 57% voted for the OG Xbox. 29% voted for the 360, and we had 14% for the PS1. Zero voted for the PS2. I don't know if I'll get to the PS1, PS2, but right now I'm going to do the OG Xbox, and then I'll be shooting a video here soon for the 360. So let's get this OG Xbox collection out of the way. Now, this is all done in alphabetical order. My whole entire collection, except for some of the stuff that's put away in the cabinet, is in alphabetical order. So here we go. I'll try to tell you guys what I played, what I haven't played, and why I collected them. Heard about this game. It's Area 51. It sounds like a great alien shooter. I've not played it yet. Stars David Duchovny as one of the voices from the X-Files. And it just sounded like a great game. I got a great deal on it a while back, so I picked it up. Love the Army Man franchise. Got this, looks like a slacker, so I haven't took the sticker off yet. Probably on a sale. The Army Man Major Malfunction. Love the title, Major Malfunction. I have not tried this one yet, but I love the Army Man games. I've played a couple of them, so I need to get this one out and try it. I bought this. Wow, back way before the game, before I even got my game room started. This was still my daughter's room when I bought this. Battlestar Galactica. I think I bought it at a store just mainly because I'm a huge Battlestar Galactica fan. I've actually never tried this game. I keep forgetting that I own it. This is a game on my backlog. This is Big Mother Truckers 1 and 2. Never went through these games all the way, but man, do I love putting these in and just being a truck driver and just running things over and just playing through these games. These games are a bunch of fun and just fun to play. Here's another set that I don't know why I've never went through these, but I need to. Blinks 1 and 2. I don't know much about them. I collected them. This was when I first started collecting games back in 2018. I started buying things. I had bought these on the PlayStation 2 and the Xbox. I think I sold my PS2 copies, but I decided to keep the Xbox ones. They usually run better than the PS2. Next up is a game that I've not played, and a lot of people have told me about it, is Black. Bones was telling me that Bones ZL6 was telling me he got through about half the game and then got stuck. But he said it's real fun. I booted up the other day, played it for about 2 hours. I'm having fun with it, but I just need to go back to it. Ended up going to another game. I took this out, and I think that's when I first put in the first Serious Sam. Been addicted to those since I got in. Blood Wake. I don't know much about Blood Wake. This is a sealed copy. Eventually, I will open it and look at it, but it looks like almost like you're on a boat with machine guns and stuff. That's why I think I bought it. Got a deal on it whenever I bought it. I need to try it, just haven't done it. In most of my sealed games, if they're sealed, I plan on playing them. I just haven't done it, and I will break the seal when I go to play. That's my thought on it. Next up, we have Blood Rain 1 and Blood Rain 2. Honestly, this was back when I first started collecting. I think I just picked them up somewhere. I've not actually tried them. These are games that are on my backlogs, but they look like the style game. Like, you're playing as a vampire assassin. Just looks like something that I would love to play, and I just haven't had time to sit down and play. why I've been off and in the quarantine situation. I have been knocking out games in my collection, just not as many as I want. Breakdown. I've seen people play this game. This game looks awesome. I have not played through it. So this is another one on my list that I need to get through. Here's two games that I own, and I have beaten both of them. I just recently went through and beat Buffy the Vampire Slayer on the original Xbox. And I beat this back in the day when I owned my first original Xbox. Me and my wife sat down. She helped me walk through it. Brute Force. It looks like it's a water-damaged copy. Whoa, this is a really bad copy. I didn't even know this was this bad. I know nothing about this game. I don't even know when I picked it up. If it's water damage like this, I probably got it in a bundle. The disc and everything inside looks great, but man, that's a rough case. I know nothing about that game. I need to play it, need to try it. Now, here's a franchise, folks, that I love and I've played millions and millions of times. I've went through every game. That's the Burnout series. I have Burnout. I have Burnout 2. I have Burnout 3 and Burnout Revenge, all on the original Xbox. Back when I went through them, on the PS2. So having them on the Xbox, they run better, they look better. So that's why I have them there. Next up, I got this here for a steal, Conker's Live and Reloaded. I paid the Xbox I have now. This was before I started collecting or even had, or right when I started collecting, but it was before I had a YouTube channel. I got an OG Xbox, two controllers, and 70 games for $65. Conker's Live and Reloaded, Jet Set Radio Future, and Panzer Dragon was in there, plus with all these other games. It was a steal, so I've had this since then. I don't remember when I picked this up, but I remember I picked it up from a guy that drove up here. I bought this and a couple other games off him for like $15. So I got the demo disc for Conker's Live and Reloaded. Crash Bandicoot Wrath of the Cortex. Honestly, I'm not a big Crash Bandicoot fan. I have problems playing it sometimes. So I have not went through this one. And I also have Twinsanity. I have Crazy Taxi 3. It looks like it's in a rental case, but it is complete. Need to get a case for that one sometime. Crimson Sea is the next one. This is a, looks like a great third-person shooter game. I had not been into it. The weird thing is the first one is on the Xbox and the second one is on the PS2. So don't know why that is. I haven't never really looked into that, but this sounds like a good game. I kept it. I was going to sell it at one point, and I looked up what it was about, and I was like, this sounds like a good game. Just another game in my backlog. I got a huge backlog, folks. Crimson Ties, High Road Revenge. I bought this real cheap somewhere. I don't remember where. Just I've played around with it a little bit, just kind of flew around. I think I bought this mainly just, I put it on the Xbox One and was playing with it on that. It's one of those titles that are upgradable to the Xbox One. Dark Watch. This is a game, it looked interesting. I remember putting it in and thinking, hey, this sounds interesting. It's got a nice ring to it. Nice playthrough. I played it for about maybe 15 minutes just to say, hey, this is one that I want to keep and the backlog. Eventually, I'll get to it. Here's two games that I've never played, and you can pretty much tell that Dead to Rights, the original, and Dead to Rights 2. This one's sealed. So, eventually, I'm going to get around to playing these. Don't know when. But they look like a great series that I would love, so we'll see. Then we have Destroy All Humans and Destroy All Humans 2. I've not played Part 2. I'm about halfway through Part 1. So once I finish this one, I'll go to this one. I have the one on the 360 and the Wii too. So these are the first one's a great game. I just haven't went all the way through it yet. This is one that I sold back during the strike, and I've just got back recently. I still got to clean it up some more. This is my Steelbook of Doom. And I'm going to tell you right now, folks, that this Steelbook isn't even in the greatest of shape compared to the one I had. This is one that I did sell again during the strike, and I've got right back recently. Got it back fairly cheap, Dino Crisis 3, and I'm waiting to... I want to play part one and part two, and I'm still looking for physical copies of those. So I will get to Dino Crisis 3. I know it's a Resident Evil style game. I've played through and tried a little bit of this game, and it was fun. So I'm waiting. I want to play part one and two first. Next up, Driver Parallel Lines. This case has seen better days. I need to clean it up. There's a lot of these I just haven't cleaned up. I just take them and throw them on the shelf. You guys see this blank space? That's where these all set up there on the top shelf. You guys have seen them. But Driver Parallel Lines, just a kind of a racing style game. I put it in, tried a little bit, and thought, hey, this is kind of fun. I could probably spend a few hours playing this, or at least try it out. It's the reason I've kept it and haven't sold it. A lot of these I've bought in bundles. Oh, now here's two games that I'm playing this one right now. It's A Fistful of Boomstick. I'm probably about three levels into it. This game is fun. When I finish that one, I will go to Evil Dead The Regeneration. So, I haven't played through The Regeneration yet, but I will. Alright, next up, fun party game. You guys can even play this on the Xbox One, Fusion Frenzy. I like it. April's not too fond of it, so... don't get to play it as much as I'd like. Here we go, folks. Gauntlet Seven Sorrows. This is an excellent game. It is fun to play. It's a four-player game, but never have anybody really come over to play them. So I've been trying to go through this by myself occasionally, but we'll see. One of these days, I might actually beat it. Grabbed by Ghouls. It's not a bad game. It's pretty fun. You can play this one on the Xbox One. Have Halo 1. And then I also, the Game of Year edition, I have Halo 2 multiplayer map. Ow, this one. Really need to clean this case up. Hot Wheels Stunt Track Challenge. I actually just like goofing off with the Hot Wheel racing games. I think they're quirky and they're kind of fun. Now, here's two games that I've been through back in the day. Me and April, we've played through Hunter the Reckoning several times. We used to love this game. It is fun. It's also on the PS2 and the GameCube. The strange thing about Hunter the Reckoning is the GameCube only got the one title. The PlayStation got that one and a different sequel, and the Xbox got Redeemer as a sequel. Now, the PlayStation 2 sequel is nothing like this one. They're two totally different things, games. And Redeemer plays a lot like Reckoning. So those of you that like the Reckoning, try to pick up the Redeemer. The only different problem is this one will play on the 360 and the Xbox One. This one here will only play on the OG Xbox. So, bummer. But it's still a great game. We have beaten both of those. I think I picked this up back when the Xbox One, they were making games compatible to the Xbox One. I've still never tried it. Jade Empire. Need to put it in and play it sometime. Magic the Gathering Battlegrounds. Really bad looking case. Need to clean it up. But I used to play Magic the Gathering back when I was in high school with my buddies. So I kind of kept it just to dabble in it. Mercenaries, Playground of Destructions, another one I bought when they released the backwards compatibility. I kind of ran out and bought them all. I got this next game. I know it's not an original artwork in there. I got it for like, it was cheaper than $5. But it's MTV Celebrity Deathmatch. And you get this game for a couple bucks. It's worth putting in just for a couple laughs. The gameplay sucks. But just remembering MTV Celebrity Deathmatch, that whole thing, that I thought that was an excellent TV show. It was hilarious. NBA Brawlers, folks. I think I picked it up at a Goodwill real cheap. Yeah, Goodwill sticker right here for $2 on it. I think I did the same thing with NFL Fever 2002, $2. Oh. Next up, Ninja Gaiden on the plate on there. I have went through this one. I have not went through Ninja Gaiden Black. Still on my backlist. Next up, we have Tim Burton's The Nightmare Before Christmas, Oogie's Revenge. Not a bad game. I love the Oddworld series on the original PlayStation. I picked this up. I don't know where I picked it up, but it's still sealed. So I need to put that in sometime. Here's the other Oddworld on the Xbox. What is it? Oddworld Stranger's Wrath. Got Outrun 2 on the original Xbox. This one I had sold back during the strike, and I actually just picked this up off a Facebook deal. And that's Panzer Dragoon Orta. The guy was selling this and a bunch of other games, so I picked it up for a decent price. We have Project Gotham Racing 1 and 2. Me and April used to love playing those back when the Xbox first came out. Psychonauts. I put this in not too long ago and played it for about 2 hours and really wasn't that big of a fan of it. Took it back out. I have not put it back in yet. I was playing it on the Xbox One. You can play it on that. I don't really care for the mechanics of it, and I'm not really into the story, so I don't know if I'm gonna finish this or not. Return to Castle Wolfenstein. I've played about halfway through this back in the day, and my save file's gone, so one of these days I'll restart this and go through it. Alright, folks, this is one that you guys have seen, and here's a newer one that I just got not too recently. Serious Sam, I put this in a couple weeks ago, started playing it, and loved this game. Then I realized I had the HD collection on the Xbox 360, so I finished this game on the 360, and I'm getting ready to start this one on the 360. I don't know if I'll live stream the second one or not, but I might. Silent Hill 4, The Room. I have 1, 2, and I have 1 on the original. I have 2 and 3 on the PS2, but somehow I picked up 4 on the original Xbox. I need to play through those. I have not done that yet. Kind of waiting to see if I get into the mood of a horror games closer to Halloween. I own a copy of Soul Calibur 2 on the PS2, GameCube, and the Xbox. This one's the one where you get Spawn. And I'm still not even into fighting games. I just kind of collected those. Alright, folks, here comes the Star Wars set. And most of these are, you can play on the Xbox One. Star Wars Battlefront. Star Wars Battlefront 2. Star Wars Jedi Knight Academy. Star Wars Jedi Fighter. Knights of the Republic. Knights of the Republic 2. Obi-Wan. Republic Commando. Starfighter. So yeah, I've got that whole stack. Bought those back when they first announced that they were, oh, these are playable on Xbox One. So I ran out and bought them so I could try to play them on the Xbox One. Next game, I've seen gameplay of this and it looks really interesting, but it's another one that just kind of dies in the collection and I forget that I own it, but State of Emergency, it looks cool. I really want to play it. Yeah, like I'm going through this collection like, man, I want to play this, I want to play this, I want to play this. I got so many games when I sat down, like, oh, I picked this one and I've been trying to stay with the game till I beat it. I live streamed this the other day, a couple months ago, I guess. We did Stubbs the Zombie, Rebel Without a Cause. We went through the whole entire game. I think it took 2 nights, but yeah, I think I did that around the end of March. Here's another set that I'm waiting to play, probably closer to Halloween. The Suffering and the Suffering, the Ties That Binds, Part 1 and 2. And Terminator Dawn of Fate. I've actually heard that this Terminator game is pretty good, so I've kept it. I've not went through it. Gonna do that sometime. I know that this probably is not good. Tron 2.0 killer app. I like to dabble in a lot of the Tron games. I'm a huge fan of the movie series that's out there, the part 1 and 2. I even like the cartoon that they had for a while. But I've not played this one. I need to try it out at least. This is a really cool and fun snowmobile racing game. I really like playing this, so. And another game, I don't go through these at all. I don't go to play them and beat them. I just like putting the Worms games in and just trying them out. But this is Worms 4 Mayhem. And that's the OG Xbox collection. So, tell me what you guys thought of those games. Tell me if there's something in here you guys saw that I said I have not played that you guys said think is one of your favorite games. Or tell me what your favorite game is on the OG Xbox that I might still need to be looking for and collect. Like I said, I'm going to do the 360 next, and it's probably double this size. I play a lot of Xbox. I have a lot of PS1 and PS2 and not very much PS3. I got a lot of PS4, but I mainly play on a lot of the Xbox systems. Haven't been doing that recently, but I usually do. So, hey, thanks for watching Retro Mikey 78. We'll be back here again soon with some more content.